Hello and welcome to an episode of Victoria 3 A to Z. Today we are playing in Germany because we are starting the letter B. B for Baden. Now this is actually a pretty good nation if you want to go for a more liberal playthrough. Because our king here is a reformer and he's part of the intelligentsia. So that should help. Now what I want to do is form a government with the intelligentsia and the landowners. And then I can go for some census suffrage, let's do that. Now for research I think we'll focus on military at first. I want to get a military advantage over my neighbors. Now let's fix the economy by taxing everyone for everything. And with the rest of the authority, let's get some decrees, like road maintenance, social mobility, agricultural industry, and greener grass campaign. Now I should probably build a construction sector, some mines, and how about a tooling workshop? Now for diplomacy, I want to rival Wittenberg and Bavaria. And then let's improve with every great power. France, Britain, Russia, everyone. I can't really attack anyone at the start because Prussia will get involved, so I guess I'll just have to wait. I should probably also get more barracks. Now I got skirmish infantry, that means I could start some wars. So the landowners are not really happy with the whole census suffrage thing. I'm not gonna lie to you, I don't think we're getting census suffrage right now. So we'll have to cancel that. Let's go for some landed voting instead. And we also got the German national identity. So a war between Austria and Prussia will happen very soon. Now I can't really attack any of my neighbors directly. But what I could do is attack this little nation and then Bavaria will get involved. But can I beat Bavaria? That's the question. They have way more units than me. But they are using line infantry. Okay, you know what? I'll go for it. What's the worst that can happen? I could actually bring Prussia in for an obligation. Let's do that. And Russia sides with those guys. Okay. Now I should probably also do some enlistment efforts and get the taxes up. And now Bavaria joined as well. But that means I'll be cut off from the Prussian market for the rest of the war. That will completely destroy my economy. Where at least I have gold reserves, that should help. Now what I also want to do is conquer the entirety of Bavaria. Let's take both of those states. Now let's just hope Prussia can carry me in this war. Okay, we're pushing in Bavaria, that's good. That's a very good sign. But the Russians are pushing in Prussia, they are already in their capital. Well, at least that guy capitulated. Okay, they're in the negatives. Come on Prussia, just a couple more weeks. Hold for a couple more weeks. Okay, we can enforce our demands. Now that's a nice looking Baden. And we can actually become Prussia's protectorate. The only reason I want to do this is because they won't be able to join against me in wars anymore. So that means I can do whatever I want in Germany. And we also got landed voting. Now let's go for Wittenberg. And even though the Prussians don't like this, there is absolutely nothing they can do. Our first election and the conservatives won. Let's try to get some cultural exclusion. Now let's annex those guys. Now I think I should probably go into the Hanover region. But I can't attack them directly because that will bring in a lot of people. So instead I'll attack Oldenburg and Hanover will also join. Let's start mobilizing everyone. Denmark joined against us but I don't think that's gonna be a problem. Okay, I don't really know what's happening in this diplomatic play but I don't want to have anything to do with this. Now I also want to take some stuff from Hanover. Like Brunswick and Hanover itself. And how about some war reps as well? Okay, thankfully we're able to push against them. Okay, Hanover capitulated. Now we still need to deal with Oldenburg. And the Prussians gave up the Rhineland to the French. Okay, you're not having a good time, are you? Okay, let's annex them. I've just cut Germany in half. Now I think it's probably time to chill for a little bit. And build up my economy and all of that until my infamy goes down. And we finally got cultural exclusion. Everybody wants to get secret police, so you know what? Let's do that. I said I'm gonna chill for a little bit, but you know, every great power is at war with each other, so I think this is a good time to attack Brunswick and also annex Hanover. Russia sides with them, but that doesn't matter, because there is no way they can get to them. There was another election, now we can get the intelligentsia and the royal folk in charge. Let's do that. Hanover capitulated, and Brunswick as well. Now let's take Bremen, I don't think anybody will get involved. Looks like no one did. We also got secret police now. Now I could try to become a republic, although it would radicalize absolutely everyone. Should I do it, just for the fun of it? Sure. But the good part about this revolution is that, well, yes, I've conquered a lot of states, but I didn't actually incorporate them. The only states I incorporated are Baden and Wittenberg. So that means if the revolution starts, they will only rise up in Wittenberg, and they'll be extremely easy to defeat. I also got an event to destroy the barracks in Wittenberg, so that means they will not have any units when they rise up. And also I forgot to mention I'm still a protectorate of Prussia, so they'll help me in the war. This civil war just can't be easier. And we also unlocked railways that should help with the market access problems. And it's done, now we should become a republic. Now let's go back to conquering small German states. You got annexed. Those guys wanna start another revolution. Now Prussia is trying to get Schleswig-Holstein from Denmark. If they get that and they also get the German leadership, they can annex all the little guys in Germany and form the North German Federation. Well, let's hope that doesn't happen. That might be happening, they are winning. Another civil war. They managed to get another civil war. Well, at least we became a republic. And now we have a new cool flag. Now we can get rid of state religions so they're not discriminating as much. We can even go for state atheism, should we do that? I mean, it gives more authority, so sure. Yeah, well, it looks like Prussia got Schleswig-Holstein. But they still don't have the leadership yet. And Italy also formed, I just noticed. And now we officially became atheist. Now let's get universal suffrage. I'm kind of bored, so I guess I'll annex some more German states. And from now on, everybody should have the right to vote. Let's also give education to everyone. Another one bites the dust. And we enacted public schools. And I will annex another one. So I tried to annex the last one and Prussia joined. And now Austria-Hungary also joined against me. And now we have a huge war on our hands. Well, those guys capitulated, but Austria is still fighting. Okay, they gave up. We enacted free trade as well. Now propertied woman. Dedicated police force. Now we got right of assembly, so that means we can also get guaranteed liberties. There we go. Now if I get national militia, I'll be able to mobilize way more battalions. So let's invite this guy, and let's make him the leader of the intelligentsia. Now let's get national militia. And we got it, national militia. Now we can get a real army. Now we don't have a lot of infamy anymore, so I guess we can start annexing some more German nations. The royal folk has abandoned the government and now they want to start a civil war. We'll see about that. And the war for German leadership has also started. This is gonna be pretty interesting. The Prussians are offering an obligation if I help them win this. I guess I would prefer Prussia to win this rather than Austria. The Austrians can be way more powerful. So I guess I'll help Prussia. Now we should start mobilizing. We are at war with Bavaria, we are also part of the German leadership war, and we'll also be in a civil war pretty soon. This is just a mess right here. Okay, at least we can annex Bavaria. Now there we have the revolution. Well, Prussia conquered Hamburg. And we're occupying the Austrian capital, but also the French are occupying our capital. So that's not great. And we also got the Communist Manifesto right now. A defensive pact with Britain. Okay, sure, why not? Austria is just taking over too many people. And Saxony became a French puppet. But the Austrians are in the negative, so maybe, just maybe, we can win this. At least the civil war is over. We did it, Austria capitulated. And now we have a North German Federation. I'm not a big fan of a big powerful Prussia, but well, at least it's better than a big powerful Austria. Also, the revolution was victorious, whatever that means. We could get Karl Marx into government. Let's do that. And we can get a council republic. That will definitely cause a revolution, but I'm gonna do it. But looks like Hesse was not really a part of the North German Federation. So I think this is the Prussians' way of telling me that I can have it. They capitulated. The intelligentsia also joined the revolution for some reason. Well, I guess now we're led by Karl Marx himself. Ah, the intelligentsia selected the communists. Now they can go back in government. Well, now we officially became a communist state. Without any civil war, actually. Now the first thing I want to do is get some proportional taxation. Look at that money. Let's get that. And we got it. Proportional taxation. Now let's get cooperative ownership. But the capitalists want to rise up against our communist ways, so we'll have to destroy them. Looks like Italy sides with them, but that shouldn't be a problem because they can't send reinforcements, so we'll still be able to crush them. And we got cooperative ownership. Now let's also get collectivized agriculture. The capitalists were finally crushed. We also got collectivized agriculture. My god, we're making so much money from this. Now let's get some health insurance. Now I guess I should probably start incorporating all the states. Because I don't think there is a risk of revolution anymore. Okay, we got public health insurance. Now how about some schools for the children? Okay. And how about some rights for the workers? Man, we're passing so many laws, it's absolutely crazy. And we're making so much money, I can afford subsidizing every single building. Because we are so rich, let's also get some old age pension. And we got it, old age pension. Now I don't think there is any other laws I want. I guess we could go for some protectionism. And we got it. Well, you see, when we're going on the communist path, our neighbors and friends in Prussia were going into the complete opposite direction. So I think it's time to go on our own separate ways and declare independence from the Prussians. This war shouldn't be too hard. Looks like Tyrol is really cheap to take, so let's do that. I also want to transfer Hohenzollern. And also give me Hamburg and Brunswick. I'm not taking this region because it will be isolated once I leave the market. The war started and I'm walking into the capital completely unopposed. Now let's enforce our demands. And now we're finally free in our own market. Well, looks like that German Federation won. And now they are the only unification candidate. But looks like they kept Hamburg. Didn't I take it in the war? I think I did. Well, anyway, now we have to deal with this. Graduate taxation will now give us more money, so let's go for that. We got it extremely fast. Now I got enlistment offices which unlock the mass conscription law. Which I think is very interesting. Because you get the best of both National Militia and Professional Army. You can conscript a crazy amount of battalions just like National Militia, but you can also build a lot of barracks if you have a lot of money. Which I do, so we'll go for mass conscription. Okay, nobody wants to get mass conscription. People just hate it. Okay, then you know what? I'm gonna attack the North Germans with whatever I have right now. Let's attack for Hamburg. And let's start mobilizing absolutely everyone. Okay, so you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do something crazy right now. I'm gonna liberate Prussia from the North German Federation. This way, I'll make both of them extremely weak and easy to conquer. Let's do that. And they have no one in the west, so I guess I can just take it over. We are not really able to push in our first battle, but at least we occupy the west. Okay, now we're pushing. The Red Army, now the armed forces, will also be communist. The Workers' Republic, now I can choose between communism, vanguardism, or anarchism. Vanguardism and communism basically give us the same things in this game. But with anarchism, we can get multiculturalism. So that's what I'll be going for. Let's get multiculturalism. And now we're occupying their capital, so they should be losing pretty fast. Okay, let's enforce our demands. Now we have the North German Federation, and then we have Prussia. And the North German Federation is completely isolated. They only have market access in those two states right here. The Prussians, however, are a little bit more powerful. We might need to do another war against them. Those guys have such low prestige, they might become a minor power. Now the Prussians got the Polish uprising, okay. I think the Prussians backed down, and now the Poles are completely free. Which means that the Prussians will now become a minor power, which is good, I guess, but now Poland exists, so I don't know how to feel about this. Now we're not discriminating anymore, no matter who you war. Okay, so let me understand this. Prussia got a Polish uprising that became independent, and now Poland is getting a North German uprising that wants independence. Okay, this whole place is a mess. Okay, so the Germans won that war in Poland, and now Prussia owns this. But now they are having a civil war. Okay, I don't even know what to say at this point about this whole region. Okay, now we finally have peace in Prussia. Now the North German Federation became an insignificant power, but they still kept the German leadership. So I still need to do a leadership play if I want to form Germany. Let's try to get mass conscription again. Okay, once again, we are not getting that. Okay, now we can start the leadership play. If nobody joins them, I think they will just give up. They are at minus 120. No, they actually want to fight. That's very surprising, to be honest. Well then, let's fight. Yeah, they don't stand a chance. Okay, they capitulated. Confederation with Baden will annex Baden. Or I get a lot of debuffs. I guess I'll annex myself. Now we just need to make the Germans like us and then we can click the button. We also annex to Hensler. And now we also got woman suffrage. Okay, now both Prussia and the German Federation support me, so I can finally click the button and form Germany. Let's do it. German unification. Now let's fix the economy. Okay, now let's annex Poland. They are fearful they might give up, but they don't. Silesia is German. Let's also make sure we incorporate every single state. But there is still more German land under foreign occupation. I'm of course referring to France, but before I attack them I should probably move my capital from here. Let's go for Bavaria. Make sure we're also mobilizing absolutely everything. But this time I'm not alone because I've been bankrolling Austria for a pretty long time now. And I have an obligation that I can use to call them into the war. So let's do that. And we can also call in Italy for a treaty port. Let's get the central powers back together. And also let's make sure I take Alsace-Lorraine and war reps. Italy joined the French. And then they abandon them. Okay then, join me. They join my side and then they abandon me as well. Why is this so realistic? Why do you always have to switch sides? Well then I guess it's only me and Austria versus France. Let's see how that goes. Okay, it's actually looking amazing. We landed very close to their capital. So now we just need to push to Paris. The Paris Commune spawned. That's the worst timing ever. I'm all for communism and that kind of stuff, but now it's just not the moment. And that, my friend, is why I moved my capital from Baden. Okay, we did it. We finally did it. We occupied Paris. Now they should be going in the negatives. Yes, they did, and I can enforce all my demands. And also Luxembourg became free, so I think it's time for them to unite with the rest of Germany. Well, Russia joined against me in this war. And what I want from the Russians is a regime change. Will that make them become the Soviet Union? Honestly, I'm not sure. But I guess we'll see. I made a landing in their capital and now they're probably gonna surrender. Well, Luxembourg capitulated, and now Russia will also capitulate. And they didn't become the Soviet Union. I can't even tell what law changed, to be honest. Well, anyway, I think this is where I'm going to end it. I created the first communist state in Germany. And I just noticed I have a lot of loyalists. Well, anyway, those are all my laws. I'm a great power, number 7 in the world, number 4 GDP, a pretty good literacy rate, and an amazing standard of living. So yeah, overall, this was a very good playthrough. Now, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel for more Victoria 3 A to Z. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.